Can you imagine an enterprise that supports food sharing practices, empowers women, and protects the environment? Well, for me, I have a hard time envisioning that because current enterprises exploit people and the environment for economic benefits. But it doesn't have to be like this. Indigenous enterprises showcase an alternative way. But before I start talking about Indigenous enterprises, let me give you some background context. Located in the Northwest Territories, Indigenous community members of Kakisa are currently growing food through vegetable gardens and greenhouses. They're doing this to alleviate some of the challenges that they've endured from climate change, colonial powers, and the global food system, which have ruined their lands and prevented them from practicing their traditional knowledge. But by growing food, community members have been able to gain control over their lands to practice their traditional knowledge. And as these food production methods increase and expand, the community will have more food than they need. So they have begun to envision what it would be like to sell food to outside communities. And that's where my research comes in. My research looks at what an Indigenous-led store that upholds Indigenous values looks like. By living in Kakisa and building strong relationships with community members, I was able to establish a relationship that was not researcher and participant. It was a friendship. And through interviewers revealed that they do not want an enterprise that sells and only distributes food. They want much more. They want a space that is centered around community building and fellowship. They want to empower women in that space by holding workshops. They want to continue sharing food as they're currently doing now. But as they have these amenities, they want to improve their economic conditions, especially living in a Western society centered on economy and growing your enterprises. So community members stated that they also want to sell fish, produce, and offer on-the-land services, such as hiking tours led by community members and hotel rooms. Therefore, unlike Western enterprises, Kakisa's Indigenous-led enterprise will enhance Indigenous culture, allow the community to have a say over their land, economies, and food systems, but above all, it will be a space that's centered around community, something that's so important in Indigenous people's values and can be found in Western enterprises. Thank you.